What is progress?
Is history since 1700 indeed the story of progress?
What factors are involved in determining progress?
This project sucks.
What did you just say?
Nothing.
Well, you boys better get started, because this project is due tomorrow.
Yes, Miss Phoebe.
Shoot, boys, we still haven't started and it's due tomorrow.
All right, let's start brainstorming.
What do you guys have so far?
This is all I got.
Yeah, me too.
All right, that's enough work for today. What do you guys want
to
do?
To the hot tub!
Oh, damn, oh, bro, come on.
All right, bro, all right. All right, all right, hey, let's go.
What are these bites?
No, don't do it, don't do it!
James, why'd you press those buttons? That was my time machine.
Oh god, where are we?
More importantly, when are we?
We're in the year 3000?
No, I just really like that song.
God. Wait, what year is it? It's 2152.
What the heck?
What is that?
I think it came from over there.
I don't know, man. I thought he was over there.
We should... We should probably check him out.
What the heck?
Who goes there? I haven't seen anyone here in ages.
Where are you taking
us? What's going on?
To my home.
Oh, my God.
So who are you?
I'm the romantic author, William Wordsworth. And you boys have been prophesied to save the Earth. But before you return to the past, you must do something vast.
What are you talking about?
Few that live know that the future is wrong. People have ruined the Earth for too long. I will put you boys on a path at which you save to find the things at which you crave.
Sorry, man. I mean, we're just travelers trying to get home.
Home is a place that we wish we all knew. But home won't exist unless the past you look to is changed, exchanged, rearranged with the new.
Wait. So are you saying that we have to change the past in order to save the future?
All of man's most grievous endeavors, two in particular, have led to great treasures. But gold do weigh heavy on the heart of man. Movement and health, do all that you can.
What do we have to do?
You must change the history which caused great frustration. Poverty in the engine and the destruction of nations. These may have been seen as good, I confess, but there is always a cost to progress.
Does progress ultimately lead to something better?
The answer you seek is contained in this letter. So go and journey to the origins of these and fix what has broken, please.
It says here, we have to kill James Watt?
What? Sir! Are you Mr. Watt?
Who's asking?
We're asking.
Yeah, that's me. What do you want? It
says here, you make a mighty fine steam engine.
Maybe I do.
Mr. Watt, we're here from the future to stop you. This engine that you're making right here, it's gonna ruin our environment.
You release greenhouse gases into our environment, such as carbon dioxide, which will destroy our ozone layer, our only protection from the sun, which will result in global warming.
Global warming? Ozone layer? What do I care? England needs to be the top of the line, and I'm gonna make that happen with my engine.
Is power really progress, though? Progress is improving something or making it better, and greater power and increased technology doesn't always do that. It has equal capability to harm, and your engine is about to do just that.
I mean, if only England has power and like all the other greater countries have power, then what about the rest of them?
Yeah.
I mean, the balance of power in the world is just going to be upset.
You think I care? I have no regard for your future. I'm living in the here and now, and I'm going to make millions.
I don't want to have to do this, Mr. Watt. There's no choice. We can't let you go through with this.
James, no.
James, what did you do, man?
It's an accident!
I sneezed, I swear!
Well, it's an accident! Well, what are we gonna do with the body?
Get rid of that!
I can't believe you killed Mr. Watt.
Yeah, I said it was an accident, jeez.
God!
You know what that means.
To the hot tub!
What the heck?
Oh my god, this place is depressing.
What? It smells awful.
What year is it?
1917.
What?
What?
Give me a
hundred. Wait. A penny for your thoughts?
I am Frank McCourt.
I'm starving and I need food for my belly. How is it that there are the rich out there who indulge in whatever they want? Then there's me, the poverty, who are hungry, and the rich share none of their wealth. It seems so unfair.
I feel you, bro.
There's so many treatments in this day and age for diseases, yet three of my siblings had to die from something easily curable. Why do we have to pay for our health?
Sometimes people are so focused on getting to the top that they forget about those on the bottom.
The rich are progressing and the poor are regressing.
Some progress, huh?
Well, thank you for your trouble, Mr. McCord. Here's $10 for your trouble.
What is this American money? I'm from Ireland!
Whew. Oh, man. That was a close one, guys. So what's next on the list?
Hey, hold up, bro. Back up. It says nothing. It says we gotta go back to Wordsworth.
Well, I mean, I guess that means...
To the hot tub!
Whoa!
What the heck?
Wordsworth, we're back. Does that mean our trip is over?
Young lads, your journey now has come to close. You've saved the world we now have come to know. The seed of thought you have begun to sow. It could be said it was done for the bros! You educated Watt, and now he knows. His engine brought pollution, now has slowed. And poor versus wealth is not how it should go. McCourt has shown free markets cons and pros. But these are only two examples seen of all the costs of progress that abound. Always there is balance in between, the good and bad that progress leaves unbound. The lessons from this that we learn and glean. Now I ask, what have you learned or found?
Whoa, Mr. Wordsworth! Was that a Petrarchan sonnet? We learned about those in our English class.
Would that give us extra points in our English class?
Yes. Yes, it would.
Why did we end up at school?
The project's due in 5 minutes!
Guys,
let's go!
Alright guys, it's time to present right now. What do we have?
James Watt? Frank McCourt?
Wait, guys. I've been recording the whole time.
Let's just turn that in.
Go ahead. Let's go.
Go.
One day when I came home at lunchtime, I heard a funny noise. To the backyard to find out if we was one of those ratty boys. Stood there with my neighbor called Peter in a flux capacitor.
He told me he built a time machine, wanted to film a scene. Yeah, he said I've been to the year 3000. Not much has changed, but they lived underwater. And your great, great, great granddaughter. You and I. He took me to the future in the flux thing, and I saw everything.
Boy bands, and another one, and another one, and another one.
Girls